But turn out of the way a little, good scholar, toward yonder high honeysuckle hedge. There we'll sit and sing, whilst the shower falls so gently upon the teeming earth, and gives yet a sweeter smell to the lovely flowers that adorn these verdant meadows. Look! Under that broad beech tree I sat down, when I was last this way a-fishing, and the birds in the adjoining grove seemed to have a friendly contention with an echo, whose dead voice seemed to live in a hollow tree near to the brow of that primrose hill. There I sat, viewing the silver streams glide silently toward their center, the tempestuous sea, yet sometimes opposed by rugged roots and pebbled stones, which broke their waves and turned them into foam. And sometimes I beguiled time by viewing the harmless lambs, some leaping securely in the cool shade, whilst others sported themselves in the cheerful sun, and saw others craving comfort from the swollen udders of their bleeding dams. As I thus sat, these and other sights had so fully possessed my soul with content that I thought, as the poet has happily expressed it. Walton, page 227, of the Library of Entertainment.
Walton, that makes sense.
It was me and not Charmander. I was just on vacation by myself, with nobody around. Yeah, I left him back at the daycare again.
Making eggs.
He seems to not want to leave that place, and I'm not sure why.
I don't blame him.
But every time I leave, it's just they must use like suction cups for their doors or something, because as soon as the door clicks, I hear.
Ooh.
But anyway, so I was relaxing, chillaxing, playing b-ball with a couple of kids from school when a couple of guys, they were up to no good.
They started to cause trouble in your neighborhood?
They did, Gracie, in fact.
Oh, no.
And so my mom got scared and they said, I'm moving with my auntie and my uncle. And,
to Bel Air?
It was more like a bridge. So like a ceiling, imagine a house with a ceiling and no walls, and it was like a community, and we and my parents dropped me off there and I never saw them again. Hey folks, welcome
That's
to this
the homeless shelter underneath the bridge
show Pokemon After Darkrai, the no holds barred, no nothing podcast. We talk about Pokemon and hurt the ones we love, baby. And boy, What can one say, Gracie? It's another one. We're here. We're
we
doing
love
it.
Everyone.
We love everyone. We're queer. Get used to it.
Hello.
Pride Month is over, almost over, but not
almost.
In our hearts.
Never.
It'll always survive in our hearts and wherever else we seem fit to express it.
Mm-hmm.
Whether it be our flags or our car magnets or posters on our walls, or with our mouths, verbally and orally, we will express that as much as we want, damn well please.
Yeah get it girl.
Put a beat to that, you got a number one hit. Gracie, what have you been up to?
Not a whole lot. I just got a proposal. Like,
ooh, you're getting married again to somebody else?
Does no, I like a conference proposal paper thing I submitted, and I got a
you're
rejection.
Getting married
letter.
To a conference? Wait, what? Wait, I'm gonna stop making light of it now. You got rejected from what now?
A conference proposal. So like you can like submit to like present at a conference or whatever. Or and whatnot. I don't know. I got my first rejection letter, so that was not great. But
oh, I'm sorry, Gracie.
It's okay.
I don't even understand half the words you said. So in my eyes, you're the smartest person I know.
Aw, thanks. But it's okay. I just have to revise and figure out what I need to do differently to make it acceptable for the world.
May I suggest vicious threats?
Mm. To the committee? I was gonna add a picture book.
You could also include the entire catalog of After Darkrai on cassette.
Oh yeah, they would. Yeah, only because no 8-track.
If you did that, Not only would they have to find an 8-track player, but they would have to listen to approximately 60 episodes before they even heard your voice.
Well, so and then
what your voice sounds like.
And then, like, depending on... No, they don't. But depending on, like, how much you can put on an 8-track, like, you might have to do a ton of them for one episode.
I mean, for sure. So, if one... I don't know about an 8-track, but if one cassette tape can have, like, what? 15 songs on per side, maybe 10 songs per side.
I guess it depends on how.
And if a song is 3 to 5 minutes a piece, I mean, do some math there.
It's a lot of cassette tapes.
I meant it. I mean, really, do some math there.
I don't want to.
So, like, about an hour on each side. So you're looking at 3 episodes of After Darkrai, maybe fitting on one cassette tape.
That'd be impressive.
I think we should do that. I think we should get cassette tapes made and we'll have like an episode on one side and another episode on the other side. And I think that'd be freaking rad.
That'd be funny.
Maybe a secret message on them only for the people who buy
and
them.
And then we can buy out some time at 3 a.m. to make an infomercial so that when kids wake up in the middle of the night and their TV is still on. Do you remember that happening to you as a child?
I do. Yes. I also remember the... compilation albums that you could buy and,
yes.
And it would play like 5 seconds of "We gotta hold on to what we," and then it would instantly switch to "I can't drive 55
yes
but I rock this thing."
Do you remember the Now CDs?
Is that like Kids Bop? I don't remember.
No, it's like
for Now Music. Now
yeah,
here's
Now Music 5
52
what was it's like Now that? Music 20. And it's like, it was basically like a burned CD, but it was official.
It was just hits.
Right? Yeah.
That's not as interesting as the Kids Bop CDs that are still being put out to this day.
I have never heard one and nor do I want to.
Oh, we're going to. Since it came up, we have to. Gracie, we have to.
I heard they did a Kids Wap.
That's what I was going to say. We did a Kids Bop Wap. I swear, I was going to, Gracie, you're not going to believe this, but they did a Kids Bop Wap.
I've heard that. I've heard that they did that.
Let me write on my adult bill here. Kids Bop Wap. I've never heard it personally, but I think it's worth investigating.
What is the title? Like, what do they change it to?
It's got
to
be Wap, right?
It can't be.
It's got, okay. Should we take bets on what we think Wap stands for in that song?
Wild something party.
We ate paschetti.
Spaghetti.
Paschetti.
Paschetti.
It's gotta be we are precious. Yeah?
Wild and
precious, wild and precious. Oh, just like us.
Yeah. But what's it? Okay? So what is it?
Fuck, I don't know.
Okay, hold on. Kids Bop.
I mean, I'm looking for it now.
I don't think it's real.
It's got. I've heard this. I've heard it before. We're gonna find out. Gracie, we should talk about Pokemon though while we do this. Gracie,
what?
We should do. Sorry. we're both so. Is it? Wait, is it Wings and Pizza?
Okay, I don't know because I looked up lyrics and it says water bottles.
Wait, what?
Water bottles.
Cold water?
I don't understand what is happening right now.
All right. Hang on a second. I tell you what, I'm going to share some audio.
Wings and Pizza.
Is it Wings and Pizza for real? Okay.
I'm pretty sure.
Hang on. This is requiring me to enter a password, and I don't know why. You guys are loving this content.
I know. Oh, no. They didn't actually do it.
It's not real?
No.
No.
But
My heart.
A YouTuber did it, and it's about foods like wings, pizza, and bread.
Well, I guess we'll have to listen to that.
Okay.
I mean, unless you can think of another Kidz Bop song that's outrageous and shouldn't exist.
I don't know. I guess I could look. You could look up like worst Kidz Bop song. Oh, there's a soundtrack to your nightmares. Top 8 worst Kidz Bop songs. I think the worst one says. LMFAO Party Rock Anthem is number one.
What? That's the most inappropriate song?
Yeah. Or maybe just annoying.
I could see that. Oh my god. So they had a Kidz Bop version of Montero, Call Me By Your Name by Lil Nas X.
Why is that? Why does that exist?
It's going to exist, and it's going to exist. You're going to get a live reaction of mine and Gracie listening to this song right now.
Let's be careful not to copyright ourselves.
If we just talk over it enough, no one will know. I called you back yesterday. You hit me with a call to your place. Ain't been out in a while anyway. Was hoping I could catch you with a smile on my face. When talking, you don't even.
Why?
This is you can only imagine why they turned the comments off of this video. Ooh. Yeah.
Don't they know what those words mean? Oh my god. I wanna sell what you're
buying. I wanna lie on. Let's go! Like from living and flying.
Put a smile on your face children. These are children. Turn it off.
Okay, hang on a second. Oh my god. Oh man. Well, I'm very glad that exists. Hey, look, I didn't make it.
I know. I'm not mad at you.
And they. Oh my god, they made a music video! Gracie! They made a music video. Oh,
are
no.
They twerking on the devil? Because if there is, please. No. Oh, kill and hunt. They're in masks. Wait.
This is the behind the scenes video.
Oh. Kidz Bop presents behind the scenes of Shake It Off. That's different. Is this the same? This isn't the same one.
No, make it stop.
Yeah, that's not it.
No, I don't like this anymore.
No.
They're just, okay, well, hold on. So these children are just cashing checks. Well, that was a fun foray into the reasons why me and Gracie are now in jail.
Oh my god, that's terrible. Like, no, like, why would you make that?
I don't know.
Why would you let your children make that?
I just
want to talk to their parents.
Cash and checks, baby.
Ma'am.
As I said before, they be cashing checks.
I know. But, ugh, gross. I get paranoid at what my, like, son watches on kids YouTube, and he's 3, and, like, I get paranoid if, like, I don't know. There was this one video he was watching, and it had a hamster in it, and it was, like, going through a maze, and it made him turn it off because they're mean to the hamster. Because they were, like, attacking it with, like, a rubber spider, and I didn't like that. Is this the YouTube one? The pizza? Wings and pizza. Stuff that crust with extra cheese.
Put some rolls in my mouth. That's
actually, like that. I actually like that. That's good. That's funny. Wings and pizza. Bring that wings and pizza. Give me all the rings. Please. Wings and pizza. Please tell me you've heard of Dojo's Cat, Cow song, Moo.
Maybe?
Dojo Cat, Moo. It is the greatest song you've ever heard in your entire life.
Okay, yeah, I have seen this. She's definitely putting some milk udders out there, isn't she?
This is my jam. I love the song.
It's literally just a lot of boobies flopping around.
Yeah. Bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. I'm not a cat. I don't say meow. I don't say meow.
Go ahead. Go ahead, Gracie. Take it.
Nope, I'm good.
Moo! What is this show about? I don't even remember anymore.
I don't know.
Nobody knows.
Dino
runs rampant in brutal swing debuts during Gin Community Day.
Yeah, Saturday.
Who could have possibly ever figured that out?
I'll be in New York.
For Dino Community Day? Dino?
Yeah, but not the city. Wow. We'll be in Rochester.
You'll be in the state.
Yeah. We're going to go to a friend's wedding, so we were like, why don't we go a day early and play community day there? And I was like, yeah.
And then, you know, drive about 12 hours down and see how to Bret.
12 hours.
Yeah, oh, why not? God.
I get motion sick. I would die.
So they're bringing back 4-star raids for this event. How do you feel about that?
I like the idea of like what they're doing with it. Like you have to catch so many or whatever. Be around a gym or stop or whatever it is.
Yeah, and then more dinos will appear if you beat the Zweilers.
I don't know. I think that's really interesting.
It's okay, I guess.
Yeah. I doubt I'll be able to do a whole lot because I'll be in a different state, so I don't know anyone.
I'll be able to do a lot either, because mostly I haven't been doing... I've been taking a break since Adventure Week ended.
Mm-hmm.
And then after the results of it... So I'm fine if I don't get a... I really want a shiny fossil, right? I want all the shiny fossils. Right. I'm fine if I don't get one, because I still have fun getting them. Unless the whole reason I do it is subverted by Niantic's dumbass eggs, whatever's in them. Okay, because so get this. So
what?
I hatched as many eggs as I could, 7K eggs.
Oh,
and
okay.
When the event ended, I had 7 left in the tank.
Okay.
Gracie, how many fossil Pokemon do you think I hatched from those 7 eggs?
1.
2. I hatched 2 Shuckles. And I hatched 3 Nekargos.
Okay.
That's 5. And then the other 2, one was a Tyrant and one was some, I think maybe a Tortuga or something, but neither of them were shiny.
That sucks.
So, yeah. So 2 out of my 7 eggs felt bad. Actually, no, wait. It wasn't a Tortuga. It was a Kranidos. So even worse.
Bad
day.
The research day, yeah.
I was going to come back and play Spinarak Spotlight Hour, and I totally forgot.
Oh, I had my toddler, and I definitely forgot. I got distracted because he wanted to go play in the heat. I don't know, understand toddlers, so he...
Series creator Taylor got a shiny Spinarak after she played for, 10 minutes, and I'm like, you bitch. Oh.
I have one from when it first came out, but I don't have the family yet. I had a lot of people saying, because Spinarak can be a Ditto, a lot of people got Dittos.
Oh, that's upsetting.
Yeah.
So, by the way, I forgot to mention, Community Day was this past weekend, and we totally played it and had a great time. And how was the wedding that you went to New York for?
Oh, it was beautiful. It was so nice outside compared to Kansas, where it's 103, but there it was 80.
And there it was more 99. That's what they said about my bedroom. I caught approximately 1 shiny Dino. That's how many I caught.
You think so?
Mm-hmm. I get 1.
You get 1. I'm going to say 3.
You got 3?
Yeah.
That's a bit on the conservative side for you, Miss Hardcore.
Yeah.
That's what they call you, right? Miss Hardcore?
Yeah.
Yeah. That was your name in high school too?
I was such a nerd in high school. There's no way.
Miss Hardcore. Ooh.
I was the band
nerd in high school. Her nickname and genre.
Genre? No! No.
Hey, there's certainly a market for Pokemon creators. I'm just going to end that thought right there. See pictures of Brett's feet on the After Dark Cry OnlyFans. What? I'm hot. Leave me alone.
No feet.
Oh yeah, you don't like feet. I forgot.
No.
It's gonna be pictures. So it's gonna be just OnlyFans, and we're gonna promise that our hosts we're gonna show reveal all, and it's just gonna be me in a banana hammock.
It's just you.
Gracie and Hannah will both be fully clothed, and it'll just be
we're just
me,
standing
like,
there like this.
Yeah. It'll be like done like a calendar style. So like every, like we rotate every 3 months.
It's just like me standing like awkward positions, but completely dressed.
All the ladies are fully clothed and me and Rahaze are just almost completely nude. Like we're just holding like a banana in front of us or something.
Fig leaf.
Yeah. At least a maple leaf.
I don't know how big fig leaves are.
Fig leaves are tiny little
things. Are they really?
I think so.
Isn't that like what they
like
had,
a maple
like,
leaf?
No, I'm thinking like, isn't that what like Adam and Eve had was like fig leaves?
Yeah, and they should have been ashamed of themselves.
There is nothing. Are you body shaming?
Clearly,
are you size shaming?
Clearly, Adam was a grower, not a shower. And yeah, fuck Adam because he blamed all his problems on Eve because she wanted to bite him an apple.
Men in general, like it's not the size that matters.
But it certainly helps.
Oh my god.
I
hate you.
Everyone does. Gracie, we should roll a Pokemon for this.
We should. Let's do that.
What a great day to be alive, you know.
The sun's still shining when I close my eyes.
It's still shining when she closes her eyes.
It's a great time in the neighborhood.
It's a great day in the neighborhood, Dad.
Also, I love that we both know this song. I feel like you had to if you grew up in like the 90s.
I don't even know what that's from.
The country song.
Is it really? God, I hate my life. Oh, I know where I know that because I used to work at a place that played nothing but country songs all day. So there is like a specific. So I think you're right too. I think there's a certain subset of people who grew up without personal music players. Like our phones couldn't have extensive libraries on them. You needed some money to have iPod. And when you had one, they were like 2 inches wide and like heavy.
I had the shuffle. I didn't have a like.
Okay. So I was a child before the shuffles existed. So, but anyway, so like all we had.
I wasn't a child.
You were never a child. You just.
I came out of the womb this way.
Oh, the womb. I was going to say birth from the heavens. Jeez. Your poor mother. Split her into pieces like a xenomorph.
When did the iPod shuffle come out? Keep going. I'm gonna look it up.
Anyway, so like we were trapped with the radio. Anywhere we went, if we was in a vehicle or like a store, you listened to the fucking radio and you liked it. So there's definitely an entire block of my brain that is devoted to the memorization of lyrics from songs from the 90s and early 2000s.
Yeah, and it was whatever, when I rode the bus to school, like, you listened to whatever was on the radio, because...
It's wild how you'll just, like, I could not recall any lyrics for you ever until I hear it, and then boom, I know the lyrics.
It's like
wait,
my life.
I hate this fucking song, but I heard it 10,000 times, I sure do. Thanks, also, Ryan Seacrest, you prick.
I looked it up, the iPod Shuffle first generation came out in 05, so I was in high school.
I had just graduated high school. So fuck you, Gracie.
I'm not that much younger, you young
stud. Look up when the first Gen 1 iPod came out, because I did have one of those, but I got one a couple years after it was out. And I think I spent like a couple hundred bucks on it. If I'm remembering correctly, I might still even have it somewhere. Wait a minute.
Did it have a screen?
It had a click wheel.
Yeah, but it had a screen though.
Yeah. And it was like analog, so like it was like an old Game Boy.
I did not have the money for this. Hold on.
They're huge.
2002.
2002. So I got one. I got one of those in high school then.
I never had one of those.
And I don't remember how many gigs was on it, but it can't be very much.
It says that the first one, the...
Do you think this still works?
Let me see. Hold on. Yes. Is that the one that could play videos too?
This is the iPod that could play videos.
Oh!
Man, that I got
like at least 30 gigs.
120 gigs is this one. Yeah, so this is after I got like started working jobs and made some money. And what a waste that became. I don't even think I have the connector to plug this sucker up.
I'm sure it doesn't even exist anymore.
Probably not. But I remember I used to be able to put episodes of Squidbillies on this thing.
Oh my god. I hated that show.
I love that show. Let's sing it.
I hated it. No, I never watched it.
My dreams are all dead and buried. Sometimes I wish the sun would just explode. When God comes and calls me to his kingdom, I'll take all you sons of bitches when I go. Number 733, it's Toucannon. Gracie, I don't
Toucannon.
Know.
Toucannon. I can't. Toucannon. Like a cannon. Like a.
Toucannon.
Yeah. Yeah.
Toucannon. But he doesn't have two cannons.
You don't know that.
He doesn't even have one cannon.
He might.
Hang on. We're going to do this.
There are gases inside its beak which can ignite and launch seeds to shatter boulders. So it's like it's two like nostrils or cannons.
Come on, Julian Miguel, help us out here.
What are you doing?
We are looking at how to pronounce this word, the name of this animal, both in British English and in American English.
Oh, wait a minute. I made a mistake.
Pronunciations differ. In British English, this is normally said as token. You do want to stress on the first syllable.
Okay, my bad. I said that was the wrong thing.
What is happening?
Julian Miguel, have you not been on an episode where Julian Miguel helps us say Pokemon words?
Uh-uh.
Okay, well, let's try this one. Let's see.
Okay.
Trevor, how to say everything.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to How to Say Everything.
Oh, no.
In today's video, you are going to learn how to pronounce Toucannon. Toucannon.
I told you.
Toucannon.
I don't know
if
I buy it.
You can purchase all things Toucannon related by visiting the link below in the description if you found this video helpful.
Okay, hold on a second. First of all, did he say that you can purchase anything related to Toucannon?
Yeah.
Toucannon in the link?
Yeah.
He does say purchase the microphone using this video, and he sounds like he's the girl trapped in the well from The Ring.
Womp.
What are we doing?
Toucannon.
It evolves from Trombig starting at level 28, and it is the final form of Pikipek. Pikipek is the woodpecker Pokemon. He loves to peck on wood.
Just like you.
It can peck at a rate of 16 times a second to drill holes in trees, just like Gracie and her ex-boyfriends. That didn't make any sense. I meant to say that you drill your boyfriend 16 times a second. I don't know. It uses the holes for food storage and for nesting, just like Gracie with her ex-boyfriends.
Why?
I don't know. The Pokemon feeds on berries, whose leftover seeds become the ammunition for the attack it fires off from its mouth. Just like me and my ex-boyfriends.
There you go. That's a better one.
It pecks at trees with its hard beak. You can get some idea of its mood or condition from the rhythm of its pecking. It's the rhythm of the night. I go walking in my sleep.
Who sings that song?
I don't know. It's another Billy Joel. I don't know who that is. It may look spindly, but its neck muscles are heavy duty. It can peck at a tree 16 times per second.
I'm still upset about Billy Joel.
Okay. What did he do wrong?
No, that you don't know who that is.
Should I? It's a
piano
singer.
Man?
He's a singer. I don't know what that is. It's a man that plays piano. Either that or it, wait. It's gonna be it's like a Masters of the Universe villain, Piano Man.
No.
No? And he's like got like keys for teeth, and like every time He-Man punches him, it's like plonk, 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 like on the piano. I like my idea better.
Song of the Piano Man, sing us.
Oh, that's like the Rocket Man. I'm the Rocket Man.
That's Elton John.
No, it's not.
Rocket Man is Elton John.
No, it's not. It's Clyde Drexler. No, it's not. Wait, who am I thinking of? William Shatner is what I meant to say.
Oh, Clyde. God.
Clyde Drexler is a basketball player.
It's the Piano Man. Sing us a song.
This is a very musical episode. Pikipek was the first Generation 7 Pokemon to be officially shown. This happened during the February 2016 Pokemon Direct. At the time, it was unnamed and appeared as a wireframe model. It is tied with Starly, Wingull, Tailow, Ledyba, Hoot Hoot, and Spearow for the lowest base defense stat of all flying types. It is also tied with Starly, Wingull, and Piodove for the lowest base special defense stat for all flying types.
Pikipek, so it sucks.
Along with its evolved form Trumbeak, are the only Pokemon to have Pickup as their hidden ability. And it seems to be based on a pileated woodpecker?
I don't know. The shiny is cool.
Is it?
Let me see. Yeah.
Yeah, that is an acceptable shiny.
It turns into a bybird.
Do you want to do Trump Beak?
Yes, except for some reason it's not loading, so.
Trump Beak, the billionaire Pokemon. Trump Beak has a bugle beak, and he's really big, loud mouth, and he likes to step on people's rights, and blame everyone else for it, while also soliciting donations from his followers to pay for shit that he don't need. Okay, yeah, you go ahead. Yours is probably more accurate.
Well, it just says, it eats berries and stores its seeds in its beak, and when it encounters enemies or prey, it fires off all the seeds in a burst. By bending its beak, it can produce a variety of calls.
Whoa!
Whoa, what?
Whoa, don't bend my beak, bro. Oh, that's dangerous. You can't bend a guy's brave beak. Especially if it's hard.
It can bend the tip of its beak to produce 100 different cries at once.
Whoa! I mean, if you really wanted to hear me do 100 different cries, you would bend the tip of my beak.
That's what it says. It cries. I don't know. I was trying to think of something funny to say and I lost it.
Kind of like my boyfriends.
I'm sorry.
It's fine.
RIP. Let's see what else. From its mouth, it fires seeds. I already did that one. Scattering seeds can give rise to new plants. Oh, that's pretty cool.
Shiny is better than Pikipek.
I gotta find the shiny one. Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's a good shiny.
Yeah.
The next one that we'll do is, of course, Toucannon. Toucannon, gotta catch him. He just looks like a really pissed off bird. Doesn't he just look super pissed off?
He looks very serious. He's got the eyebrow thing going on.
He looks like he's about to smack a bitch.
Yeah, like, well.
He's boiling with rage at the moment. When it battles, its beak heats up. The temperature can easily exceed 212 degrees Fahrenheit, super specific, causing severe burns when it hits.
Well, do you know why it's 212?
Why?
Because that's the temperature that water boils.
Oh.
You're welcome.
Thanks. Within it, I'm glad one of us is smart. Within it is beak, its eternal gas ignites, explosively launching seeds with enough power to pulverize boulders. They smack beaks with others of their kind to communicate. Hey, that's funny. That's kind of like what we do on this show. We just slap each other's beaks together.
Also, I want to make a joke about it's firing its seed at people.
Yeah, go ahead. I won't stop you.
I just did it. Oh. Seed, get it?
Semen. No, I don't. Semen, as in like the Navy soldiers.
Yes, yeah.
Oh.
They call them seeds sometimes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I hear they're also referred to as like sticky tadpoles, but I don't know why.
Yeah, it's weird.
Come dumpster. The strength and number of hits tell each other how they feel. Known for forming harmonious couples, this Pokemon is brought to wedding ceremonies as a good luck charm. I don't think you should be bringing this Pokemon anywhere.
Yeah, spitting seed at people.
He's kind of an asshole.
And when he gets mad, he like boil water at you. Like, that's not like, I don't want that at my wedding.
But look at this shiny.
It's a bi bird.
Oh yeah, I guess it is. It's dope. Yeah. That is such a good.
I like it.
I don't like how he's a woodpecker and then he turns into a toucannon or a two.
Yeah, those are two different birds.
Toucan. Yeah, it's weird. I don't know.
Well, just like, what is it? It's like the octillery is from a fish to an octopus. Like,
I think there was an actual like decent reason for that one.
I don't think
I mean, this isn't the episode for that, but
I know, but I'm just like, I don't
I think there was a decent reason for that.
Okay. I'll
believe
it.
Why does octillery?
Oh my god.
I can't type. Octillery evolved from Remoraid. Hang on.
I'm waiting.
Oh, that's right, because Remoraid at one point was a revolver, and Octillery was a tank, so it was like a revolver evolved into a tank.
Okay, but fish and octopus.
Right, but I'm just saying, one was a gun and one was a tank, and that was
the
connection.
Yeah, so make it like a squid into an octopus or something.
And then they changched it. They dialed down the gun and tank to just fish and an octopus.
To make it less violent on a game about animals fighting each other.
Right, because, yeah. Of course.
Makes sense. Checks out.
Let's see here.
But yeah, I don't know. I would not want to cross this bird, that's for sure. Be mad.
Yeah, that bird's the bird is real pissed off.
He weighs 50 pounds. That's a big bird.
Aren't toucannons big? Or toucannons? Toucans. God damn it. I'm trying to actually say toucans and can't do it.
I don't know. I don't think they're 50 pounds.
Since this has been such a magical episode, check the chat, by the way. This is we need to do a song for Toucannon. We haven't done a song very much lately, so.
Okay, I'm opening.
How can we... it's a picture of... my boy destroyer days.
Okay. All right.
My Mr. Yep. Hard, back when I was a Mr. Hardcore, circa 2005. I had eyeliner and semen for days.
Wow.
You got a song or what?
This
is how you know this show is improvised, because sometimes we just got nothing.
Toucannon.
Wait, I did that one. You can't do that. That's cheating.
Toucannon.
Oh, thank you. Okay, go ahead. I won't interrupt anymore.
Toucannon. Make you fannin. I don't. Hot hannin. I don't know.
I didn't mean like. You don't necessarily have to create a brand new song, you know.
Oh, I was making shit up.
Like, what's a good Nick Cannon song? Do we know any of those?
I don't even know who that is.
You don't know who Nick Cannon is? Divorced husband of famously divorced from Mariah Carey.
I don't know who that is. I know who Mariah Carey is, but I don't know who he is.
He hosts like a bunch of shows. You know who Nick Cannon is.
Pop, I guess maybe I do, but I don't recognize the name.
All I want for Christmas is Toucannon. All I want for Christmas. Okay, that's enough. I don't want to. If I could sing, boy, would I.
And I will love Toucannon.
No. Well, this is why we don't do this segment anymore, because it's bad.
I'm bad.
It's not good. But you know who it's not bad is our dear listeners. Thank you so much for sticking with us all the way. Baby, from cradle to grave, we know. Tattoo's looking fly today, Grace.
Yeah. I got a new one.
Oh, yeah? Let's see it. Check it out on YouTubes. Is it the D20?
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Oh. That's a good idea for like a matching tattoo with like a friend or a loved one. One of them you get like the 20 and the other one gets the nat 1.
That's adorable.
I think that'd be cool.
Yeah.
I always thought, I always try to get my friend Taylor to get like a little like mug right here on her hand, and I'll do the same thing, and then we can clink them together.
Aww.
Yeah. You can follow me on twitch.tv/breakerisdead. You can also find all the links for our socials on our, at our link tree in the description below. You just click that link and it's got Instagram, Twitter for not only After Dark Rye, but Pod Dog and Jaws Breakers, the Scary Funny Shark Show. Speaking of which, July 9th, Gracie, is that one of those?
I think you said, yeah.
I believe so.
Early July.
Saturday, July 9th, 7 p.m. Eastern, we are watching a little movie called Shark Night 3D and featuring one, the Gracie Z. Rain. If she can make it, no worries if she can.
Yeah, pretty sure I can.
Fantastic. So that'll be lovely to have her on that. There is a dog in this shark movie, but in keeping with my inability to watch movies where dogs get hurt in any way, shape, or form, I went ahead and spoiled it for everyone in the podcast. The dog does not die. So
okay, good. I was like, I can't watch it if it.
Looking forward to Shark Night 3D. Join us. We're watching it on my Twitch, twitch.tv/breakerisdead. Okay. Also, follow Gracie at Gracie Z. Rain. Nope. No?
Lady Z. Rain. Oh.
Lady. Uh-oh. Lady Z. Rain.
Art. On the Instagram. Oh, Twitch is
This is where I get confused. Sorry. Twitch is V as in Victor, Grace, G as in Gracie, R as in Racy, A as in AC, C as in C, I as in I, E as in E. Oh my God!
You spelled it! And Z as in Zebra.
Z as in Zebra, or Zulu.
You
can find those links in the description as well. As Twitter at Lady Z Rain and Instagram at Lady Z Rain Art. I edited that back in. Before we go, today's very special episode is brought to you by a very special sponsor.
Yeah.
So before we end the show, Gracie, we're gonna do the sponsor. We'll come back. We'll get anything you want to talk about in there.
Okay.
And we'll do that in just a minute. Hang on, I gotta play this pre-recorded ad.
Yeah.
Here we go.
God, I hate this.
After Dark Rye is brought to you by Machoke brand collars. When you just need to get a good tight fitting leather band, possibly with some chain links, wrap,
got some spikes going on,
firmly around your neck. And sometimes you can also get the extreme versions where you got the neck where the spikes are on the inside of the collar. Mm-hmm. Yeah. One size fits all stainless steel.
Adjustable.
So you don't have to worry about these things rusting. You can get them wet with any substance for any amount of time. Except lava. Don't wear the collars around lava. But we're only here to talk about what they are good at. So, I mean, I know, Gracie, you and me, we've both just been on our knees looking for a perfect collar to meet are very serious hardcore needs, and Machoke brand choke collars deliver on all fronts. They are durable.
On all fronts.
They're durable. They're long lasting. They're made from quality materials, and not
just
only
like
that,
my fiance.
That's right, and just like my girlfriend, they're also comfortable. And they have this fantastic little name tag that doubles as a ring so that you can attach a collar should you need to be tied up outside of a store or put in a corner to think about what you've done. Gracie, you were shipped a package of these brand new Machoke brand Choke Daddy collars. What was your experience with them?
Just so you know, you'll never know.
Oh, and but you'll know, dear customer, when you use the offer code After Dark Ride Daddy. Enter that code and receive 10% off your next order. My choke brand choke daddy collars for daddy. Daddy collars for your daddy. So good, but you'll never know.
I hate that music so much.
We are back. Gracie, I don't know what you're talking about. What a great episode that was. Truly. Truly, truly, truly. And Gracie, is there anything you'd like the people to know before we sign out for the day?
That consent is important and happy Pride Month.
Oh, okay. Absolutely. I agree with you.
Yeah. Why did you say what's the stuff for?
I was just confused for a split second. yeah, folks. Don't forget to give thanks to the Machoke Daddies above, and we will see you next time on this show called Pokemon After Darkrai. And Gracie, do you want to do the thing?
Do you want me to do the first part?
Sure, I don't care. Or do you want to do the second part? Because I'll do the second part.
After Darkrai.
No.
Oh.
No.
No, after... Dang it. I mess it up every time. You do it first.
Okay. After you're full to bursting...
Darkrai will leave you thirsting.
Ooh, mommy. Two cannot do what one can.
Can do better.
Two cannot do what one can do better. That sounds like a you had it. I was gonna say that sounds like a 80s TV show thing.
No,
you say
one is the loneliest number is like.
No, that's what yours was. That's mine was something different. Yeah. Two is the loneliest number that Nick can do. He's got 12 children and he's not gonna stop because he's the. I don't know. He makes it go flop because he makes it go flop.
Flop.
We can keep trying all day till the cows come home. Moo.
Boo, bitch, get out the way.
That's a different song. I was kind of talking about your moo song.
I know. She says, oh, wait, moo, bitch, get off my hay. Get off my hay.
She says that in the song?
Yes!
What?
Oh, that's such a great song. Go listen to it when you're done. Okay.
How about we just do it right now?
Because we're done.
Yeah, but this is the bit that people get it if they listen through the credits.
You can listen to the whole song. It's really long. Or just gonna fast forward.
I'll just switch to the middle where we kind of left it.
I don't know exactly where it's at though.
I don't know either, but
you have to edit that part. Old McDonald had I get to the city trying to keep him calm. I'm just trying to turn up in the country. I ain't in the city because they ain't got lawns. Suck a nigga dick or something.
Okay, well, goodbye.
Yeah, you'd edit that part out.